हेलो नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ फ्लैश कार्ड्स। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस द बेस्ट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल 2020। सो लेट्स बिगिन गाइस विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज आर ट्रू अबाउट द नवरत्नलु पेडलान डरेकी इल्लू स्कीम ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश। सो अंडर दिस स्कीम द आंध्र प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट विल डिस्ट्रीब्यूट 25 लाख हाउस साइट्स टू द पुअर इन अर्बन एंड रूरल एरियाज। दीज हाउस साइट्स will be allotted at ₹1 under this scheme and the beneficiaries cannot sell the house site until they occupy the house for 5 years and this scheme has been launched by the government of Andhra Pradesh as a part of Navratna schemes. So therefore guys, the correct answer to this question is E, all of the above. So all of the above statements about the scheme is correct and the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh is YSR Jagan Mohan Reddy. Now next question. Directorate General of Foreign Trade has decided to extend the existing foreign trade policy 2015-20 for dash years due to coronavirus outbreak. So guys, DGFT ने decide किया है कि जो हमारी foreign trade policy है 2015-20 को, उसको एक साल बढ़ा दिया जाएगा because of this coronavirus outbreak. So therefore guys, the correct answer is A, 1 year. And this DGFT works under Ministry of Commerce and Industry headed by Piyush Goyal. And the current Director General of DGFT is Mr. Amit Yadav. DGFT, it is headquartered in New Delhi. According to the new domicile law for Jammu and Kashmir, a person needs to reside for at least dash years in JNK to become a permanent resident of the UT. So to become a permanent resident of the UT, a person has to reside for at least 15 years. For at least 15 years in Jammu and Kashmir to become a permanent resident. So therefore the correct answer is B, 15 years. Other than this, agar koi student Jammu and Kashmir mein 7 years ke liye study kar raha hai aur usne class 10th ya phir 12th ke exams diye hain to wo bhi permanent resident mana jayega of the Jammu and Kashmir. Iske alawa jo central government officials ke childrens hain, jo ki aise central government official jo ki Jammu and Kashmir mein pichle 10 saal se ya usse zyada se serve kar rahe hain, तो उनके चिल्ड्रंस को भी परमानेंट सिटीजंस करार दिया जाएगा। राइट, सो मिनिमम कितना है? 15 साल। इसके अलावा कोई स्टूडेंट अगर 7 साल के लिए जम्मू कश्मीर में पढ़ रहा है और उसने 10th और 12th का एग्जाम दिया है तो वो परमानेंट रेजिडेंट होगा जेएनके का। इसके अलावा कोई सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल जो कि 10 साल या उससे ज्यादा से काम कर रहा है इन द जेएनके, तो उनके जो चिल्ड्रन होंगे उनको भी परमानेंट सिटीजन के लिए एलिजिबल किया गया है। राइट, वट इज द नेम ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव लॉन्च बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सिविल एविएशन for supplying medicines and essential goods across India in the wake of coronavirus outbreak. Ministry of Civil Aviation is headed by Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri, he is Rajya Sabha MP from Uttar Pradesh and he is also the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs. So the correct answer to this question is, the name of the initiative is Lifeline Udaan. A, Lifeline Udaan. To which country has Indian Air Force delivered 6.2 million tons of essential medicines under its Operation Sanjeevani? So under the Operation Sanjeevani, 6.2 million tons of essential medicines has been supplied to Maldives. Alright, has been supplied to Maldives. Maldives capital is Male. Which ministry has launched the Center for Augmenting War with COVID-19 Health Crisis, or in short we can say Kavach, at a cost of ₹56 crores. So guys, this Kavach has been launched by Department of Science and Technology. This department works under Ministry of Science and Technology. Okay, Ministry of Science and Technology, it is headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. Dr. Harshvardhan, his Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk. And this will be implemented by Society for Innovation and Entrepreneurship, which is at IIT Bombay. Which state has the highest area under micro irrigation in 2019-20 according to the website of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana? So according to the website of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, the best state under micro irrigation in the year 2019-20 is Tamil Nadu. So B, Tamil Nadu is the correct answer. Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu is Palani Swami. Alright, Edappadi K. Palani Swami is the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. When was the MP Local Area Development Scheme launched? So guys, this scheme was launched in the year 1993 and this scheme was in news because recently cabinet has decided to withdraw the scheme for 2 years, 2 साल के लिए इस स्कीम को रोक दिया गया है ताकि इसमें से जो फंड बचेगा उसको COVID-19 से लड़ने के लिए लगाया जा सके. ऑलराइट, एंड दिस स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 1993. अंडर दिस स्कीम 5 crore हैज बीन गिवन टू एन एमपी फॉर द लोकल एरिया डेवलपमेंट. इस स्कीम के अंदर 5 crore रुपए एक एमपी को दिए जाते हैं ताकि वो अपने एरिया में डेवलपमेंट करा सके. एंड दिस स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 1993 एंड राइट नाउ ये स्कीम सस्पेंड कर दी गई है फॉर 2 years. When was the DigiLocker launched? So DigiLocker was launched in the year 2015 by Ministry of IT and Electronics, and this was in news because recently Ministry of HRD has designated DigiLocker as the sole national academic depository. ये इसलिए न्यूज में था because recently MHRD ने DigiLocker को designate किया है as the sole National Academic Depository and it was launched in the year 2015 by Ministry of Electronics and IT. What is the name of the scientist who developed the biofortified carrot named as Madhuban Gajar? Madhuban Gajar has been developed by Vallabhbhai Vasrambhai Marwaniya. Alright, Vallabhbhai Vasrambhai Marwaniya and inko 2019 mein Padma Shri bhi mila tha in the field of agriculture. Okay. How many people are expected to enter in poverty in India according to COVID-19 and World of Work report of ILO? Guys, ILO, it is headquartered in Geneva and it is headed by Guy Ryder. It is headed by Guy Ryder and according to this report, 400 million people are expected to enter in poverty in India. And as per this report, COVID-19 crisis is expected to wipe out 6.7% of working hours globally in the second quarter of 2020, which is equivalent to 195 million full-time workers. And in Arab countries, around 5 million full-time workers are expected to lose their jobs, while in Pacific and Asia, around 125 million will lose their jobs because of the menace of COVID-19. Government has launched an online training module known as iGOT on Diksha platform. Diksha stands for Digital Infrastructure for Knowledge Sharing, and on this platform of Ministry of HRD. So we have to tell the full form of iGOT. So guys, iGOT stands for Integrated Government Online Training. Integrated Government Online Training, and this portal has been launched to train those frontline health workers who are working to fight against COVID-19, alright? Which state or UT has launched the Operation Shield for the containment zone to contain the spread of coronavirus? Coronavirus ke spread ko contain karne ke liye Operation Shield kaun se state ya kaun se UT ne launch kiya hai? So guys, in Shield, S stands for ceiling, H stands for home quarantine, I stands for isolation and tracing. E stands for essential supplies. And L stands for local sanitation. And finally, D stands for door-to-door checks. All right, door-to-door checks. So this is the full form of SHIELD, and this Operation SHIELD has been launched by the government of Delhi. So therefore the correct answer is B, Delhi. Who is the chairperson of Telecom Disputes Settlement Appellate Tribunal? So jo ye Telecom Disputes Settlement and Appellate Tribunal hai, iske chairperson ko dobara se appoint kiya gaya hai, and the name of the chairperson is Justice Shiva Kirti Singh. Now guys, next question is, what is the name of the initiative launched by the Niti Aayog, Atal Innovation Mission and National Informatics Centers to allow students of Atal Tinkering Labs to innovate in 2D drafting and 3D product design? Atal Tinkering Lab ke students ko help karne ke liye to innovate in 2D drafting and 3D product design, नीति आयोग और अटल इनोवेशन मिशन एंड साथ ही साथ नेशनल इन्फॉर्मेटिक सेंटर ने एक इनिशिएटिव लॉन्च किया है, एंड द नेम ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव इज कोलाब कैड. ऑलराइट, कोलाब कैड. व्हिच कंट्री हैज अप्रूव्ड to sell torpedoes, lightweight missiles and harpoon air-launched missiles to India at a cost of $155 million. So at a cost of $155 million, torpedo, lightweight missiles and harpoon air-launched missiles India ko bechega, the United States of India. So the correct answer is C, USA. Ministry of HRD has launched the Yukti portal to monitor initiatives launched by MHRD for COVID-19. What does T stands for? So guys, Yukti stands for Young India Combating COVID with knowledge, technology and innovation. Alright, Young India Combating COVID with knowledge, technology and innovation. And this portal has been launched to monitor those initiatives which are launched by Ministry of HRD for fighting against COVID-19. So therefore T stands for guys, C, technology. Next question is, who heads the Development Council of 25 members for development of pulp, paper and allied industries? So the correct answer to this question is A.S. Mehta. A.S. Mehta heads the Development Council of 25 members for development of pulp, paper and allied industries. Which state has launched a mobile application, Unnayan, Mera Mobile, Mera Vidyalaya, for class 6th to 12th of over 70,000 government run schools? So guys, this app has been developed by UNICEF, Bihar government and Echovation. Alright, so therefore guys, the correct answer is D, Bihar. Is app ko launch kiya hai UNICEF ne, Bihar government ne aur Echovation ne, aur isko Bihar ki government ne launch kiya hai for class 6th to 12th of over 70,000 government run schools. Which organization has launched the Sahyog mobile app to complement the Arogya Setu app? Guys, this organization is the oldest scientific department of India. It is the oldest scientific department of the government of India. It was established in the year 1767 and it is headquartered in Dehradun. It is basically a national survey and mapping organization of India. And the name of the organization is D, Survey of India. Alright. Which state has launched two portals, Annapurna and Supply Mitra, to fulfill the food demand of the citizens of the state during the COVID-19 crisis? So this Annapurna portal is to provide knowledge of food products to the consumers, and this Supply Mitra is to deliver the food at the doorstep free of cost. Okay, Supply Mitra jo portal tha ye kis liye launch hua tha, taki food delivery ki ja sake free of cost, and Annapurna was launched to spread knowledge about the food products to consumer, and these two portals has been launched by the government of Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath. Who heads the panel which has submitted its report on valuation professionals to the government? He is the chairperson of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. His name is Mr. M.S. Sahu. What is the tagline of Kisan Rath mobile app? Kisan Rath mobile app ki hame tagline batani hai. So guys, this Kisan Rath mobile app was launched to strengthen the agricultural supply chain management. Jo agriculture ka jo supply chain management hai, usko strengthen karne ke liye this app was launched, and this app has been developed by National Informatics Center. Okay, NIC ne isko develop kiya hai, and ye kyun launch kiya gaya tha, taki jo agriculture ka supply chain management hai usko strengthen kiya ja sake during the coronavirus pandemic. Okay, and the tagline of this app is Kisan ka apna vahan. Kisan ka apna vahan. India's energy subsidies fell by dash percent during financial year 17 and financial year 19 according to the Mapping India's Energy Subsidies 2020 report. So according to this report, India's energy subsidies fell by 35% during financial year 17 and financial year 19, while there is an increase of 65% in the oil and gas subsidies. Oil and gas subsidies mein increase aaya hai by 65%, while India's energy subsidies fell by overall by 35% according to Mapping India's Energy Subsidies 2020 report. Alright. What is the production target for rice for 2021 as per the Ministry of Agriculture? So guys, total जो हमारा target है, total grain production का जो target है, that is 298.3 million ton है. And out of this 298.3 million ton, 117.5 million ton is for rice. So therefore the correct answer is 117.5 million ton. What is the new limit of the guarantee of default loss given by government to the banks under the credit guarantee fund for micro unit scheme? So guys, under this scheme, earlier there was a limit of 50%. Now the limit has been increased to 75%. 75% इसकी लिमिट बढ़ा दी गई है और इससे क्या होगा, जो माइक्रो यूनिट्स है उनको लोन लेने में आसानी होगी और वो लोन लेने के लिए एनकरेज होंगे. राइट, विच स्टेट हैज बिकम द फर्स्ट स्टेट इन इंडिया टू जियो टैग कम्युनिटी किचन्स इन 75 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स? सो ऐसा करने वाला जो पहला स्टेट है दैट इज उत्तर प्रदेश. राइट, एंड उत्तर प्रदेश सीएम वी ऑल नो इट इज योगी आदित्यनाथ. Which state has launched the Chief Minister COVID-19 Yodha Kalyan Yojana to provide health insurance of rupees 50 lakh to Anganwadi workers and assistants? So, ऐसा करने वाला जो state है, that is Madhya Pradesh. Alright, and Madhya Pradesh newly appointed Chief Minister is Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Okay, so under this Chief Minister COVID-19 Yodha Kalyan Yojana, Madhya Pradesh will provide an health insurance of rupees 50 lakhs to Anganwadi workers and assistants. So therefore the correct answer is A, Madhya Pradesh. Which state has launched the third phase of Sujalam Suflam Jal Sanchay Abhiyan to conserve rainwater? So this scheme third phase has been launched by the government of Gujarat. Alright, Sujalam Suflam Jal Sanchay Abhiyan has been launched by the government of Gujarat. Gujarat Chief Minister is विजय रूपानी. When was विद्यादान नेशनल प्रोग्राम launched? So guys, विद्यादान 1.0 was launched in the year 2019 and recently विद्यादान 2.0 was launched. Okay, विद्यादान 2.0 recently launch किया गया था ताकि अगर कोई इंडिविजुअल या कोई सोसाइटी या कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विलफुली अपना कंटेंट डोनेट करना चाहता है ऑन द दीक्षा पोर्टल, ताकि जो हमारा ई लर्निंग का इकोसिस्टम है उसको स्ट्रेंथन किया जा सके. ऑलराइट, क्योंकि अभी स्कूल और कॉलेज खुल नहीं रहे हैं तो जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनको ई लर्निंग कंटेंट प्रोवाइड कराना है. सो अंदर विद्यादान 2.0 जो भी इंडिविजुअल है या जो भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है अगर कोई अपना कॉन्टेंट डोनेट करना चाहता है तो वो कर सकता है और ये जो कॉन्टेंट है ये यूज किया जाएगा ऑन द दीक्षा पोर्टल ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ HRD. सो विद्यादान नेशनल प्रोग्राम वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2019 and recently Vidyadan 2.0 has also been launched. Which state has launched the EOPD facility on the e-Sanjeevani portal of the Government of India to allow the citizens of the state seek basic medical consultation from doctors digitally? Okay, तो ऐसा करने वाला जो state है that is Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh has launched the EOPD facility on the e-Sanjeevani portal and Himachal Pradesh Chief Minister is Jairam Thakur. जयराम ठाकुर पार्टी इज भारतीय जनता पार्टी. When was the रविंद्र एच ढलकिया कमिटी formed by मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इंप्लीमेंटेशन फॉर रिव्यूइंग द मेथडोलॉजी ऑफ एस्टिमेशन ऑफ सब नेशनल अकाउंट्स? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इंप्लीमेंटेशन इज हेडेड बाय राव इंदरजीत सिंह. सॉरी, it is headed by Rao Inderjit Singh. His Lok Sabha constituency is Gurugram. In Gurugram, you will find the headquarter of International Solar Alliance. So this committee was formed in the year 2018. Alright, 2018. What is the name of the Yojana launched by Prime Minister for mapping of properties or lands in villages? So guys, this Yojana was launched on the National Panchayati Raj Day. National पंचायती राज डे जो कि 24 अप्रैल को ऑब्जर्व किया जाता है फ्रॉम द ईयर 2010 एंड द नेम ऑफ द स्कीम इज स्वामित्व स्कीम. ऑलराइट, स्वामित्व स्कीम. एंड इसके अलावा एक और पोर्टल लॉन्च किया था जिसका नाम था ई ग्राम स्वराज ऐप. ऑलराइट, ई ग्राम स्वराज ऐप एंड पोर्टल भी लॉन्च किया गया था ऑन द सेम डे दैट इज नेशनल पंचायती राज डे विच इज ऑन 24th April. What is the production target set for Coal India Limited for financial year 2020-21? So, जो Ministry of Coal है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोल ने 1 बिलियन टन का टारगेट सेट किया है ऑफ फॉर द कोल प्रोडक्शन बाय द ईयर 2023-24, 2023-24 तक 1 बिलियन टन का जो प्रोडक्शन है वो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोल ने टारगेट सेट किया है. एंड फॉर द ईयर 2020-21 द प्रोडक्शन टारगेट हैज बीन 710 मिलियन टन का कोल प्रोडक्शन का टारगेट सेट किया है मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोल ने फॉर द ईयर 2020-21. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोल इज हेडेड बाय प्रहलाद जोशी. हिज लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज धारवाड़ विच इज इन कर्नाटका. ऑलराइट, धारवाड़ विच इज इन कर्नाटका एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री अफेयर्स. हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ नेशनल शिपिंग बोर्ड. सो द न्यूली अपॉइंटेड चेयरपर्सन ऑफ नेशनल शिपिंग बोर्ड इज मालिनी शंकर. रिसेंटली ऑस्ट्रेलिया हैज कैंसल्ड द पिच ब्लैक 2020 मल्टीलैटरल एयर कॉम्बैट ट्रेनिंग एक्सरसाइज ड्यू टू द COVID-19 सिचुएशन. विद विच कंट्री डज ऑस्ट्रेलिया होस्ट दिस एक्सरसाइज. सो ऑस्ट्रेलिया होस्ट दिस एक्सरसाइज विद इंडिया. लास्ट टाइम इट वॉज हेल्ड इन द ईयर 2018 एंड नाउ इट विल बी हेल्ड इन द ईयर 2022 बाय ऑस्ट्रेलिया अलॉन्ग विद इंडिया. वेयर इज द हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंटर अथॉरिटी. सो द हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंटर अथॉरिटी हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड इन गांधीनगर विच इज इन गुजरात. ऑलराइट, गांधीनगर विच इज इन गुजरात. एंड रिमेंबर जो पहला इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंटर था दैट वॉज ओपन्ड इन द गिफ्ट सिटी. ऑलराइट, गिफ्ट सिटी विच इज इन अहमदाबाद ऑफ गुजरात. ऑलराइट, अहमदाबाद ऑफ गुजरात. हाउ मेनी इंडियंस वर इंटरनली डिस्प्लेस्ड इन 2019 एज पर द ग्लोबल रिपोर्ट ऑन इंटरनल डिस्प्लेसमेंट ग्रिड 2020 रिपोर्ट. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट 5 million Indians वर इंटरनली डिस्प्लेस्ड इन द ईयर 2019. ऑलराइट, वट वॉज द ग्लोबल लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी एट बर्थ फॉर बोथ सेक्सेस कंबाइंड इन द ईयर 2016 अकॉर्डिंग टू वर्ल्ड हेल्थ स्टैटिस्टिक्स 2019 मॉनिटरिंग हेल्थ फॉर द SDGs रिपोर्ट ऑफ WHO. WHO इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन जेनेवा. इट इज हेडेड बाय टेड्रोस आदनॉम. एंड देर आर 17 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स एंड देर आर 169 टारगेट्स एंड दी 17 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स आर टू बी अचीव्ड बाय द ईयर 2030. ऑलराइट, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट 72 The global life expectancy at birth for both sexes combined in the year 2016 is 72. In the year 2000, it was 66.5. तो इसमें 5.5 का increment होके अब ये 2016 में हो गया है 72. Alright. How many people will additionally come under poverty in the East Asia and Pacific region according to World Bank's East Asia and Pacific in the time of COVID-19 April 2020 update. So guys, according to this report, according to this update, 11 million people will come additionally under poverty in the East Asia and Pacific region. What is the GDP growth rate of India for the year 2020-21 according to United Nations Economic and Social Survey of Asia and Pacific 2020 report. So according to this report, GDP growth rate of India for the year 2020-21, it is 4.8%. For the financial year 22, it is 5.1%. और इस report के हिसाब से 2020 में जो पूरे world का GDP growth होगा, that will be 2%. Alright, पूरे world का GDP growth in the year 2020 is 2%. एंड 2021-22 में इंडिया का जो जीडीपी ग्रोथ का फोरकास्ट है इट इज 5.1 एंड फॉर फाइनेंशियल ईयर 21 इट इज 4.8%. WTO वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन जेनेवा हैज रिलीज्ड इट्स एनुअल ट्रेड स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड आउटलुक रिपोर्ट विच मेंशंस दैट ग्लोबल ट्रेड विल फॉल बाय -% ड्यू टू द COVID-19 पेंडेमिक. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट The global trade will fall by 13-32% due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, and WTO chief is रॉबर्टो एजेवेडो, राइट, एंड इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन जेनेवा. विच कंट्री हैज टॉप इन द वर्ल्ड प्रेस फ्रीडम इंडेक्स 2020? सो दिस वर्ल्ड प्रेस फ्रीडम इंडेक्स हैज बीन रिलीज बाय एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच इज नेम्ड एज रिपोर्टर्स विदाउट बॉर्डर्स नाम की ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ये प्रेस फ्रीडम इंडेक्स निकालती है हर साल. एंड दिस इज लोकेटेड इन पेरिस विच इज इन फ्रांस. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस इंडेक्स नॉर्वे इज एट नंबर वन एंड इंडिया हैज बीन रैंक एट वेरी पुअर 142 विथ अ स्कोर ऑफ 45.18. ऑलराइट, सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ए नॉर्वे. Which has become the first Arab country to legalize the farming of cannabis for medical use to fight against the economic crisis caused by COVID-19. So this country, guys, is Lebanon. Okay, this country is Lebanon and Lebanon capital is Beirut. What is the name of the China's first Mars exploration mission? So the name of the China's first Mars exploration mission, it is Tianwen-1. Alright. Tianwen-1, and the name comes from the long poem which is known as Tianwen, and Tianwen means questions to heaven. This poem has been written by Qu Yuan, which is one of the greatest poets of ancient China. Which organization has developed the first ever unified geologic map of the moon? So US Geological Survey's Astrology Science Center has developed the first ever unified geologic map of the moon in partnership with NASA and Lunar Planetary Institute ke saath milke US Geological Survey's Astrology Science Center has developed the first ever unified geologic map of the moon. Which Indian institute is at the highest rank in the Times Higher Education Impact Ranking? So under the impact ranking, the Indian institute which got the highest rank, it is IIT Kharagpur. Aur IIT Kharagpur ka jo overall ranking tha, that was 57th, and jo isme number one ranking hai wo hai University of Auckland. According to the CIPRI's annual data on global military expenditure, India is the dash largest spender in the world in 2019. So in the 2019, India is the third largest spender in military in the year 2019. And according to this report, the top five military spenders are USA, China, India. At number 4, it is Russia, and at number 5, it is Saudi Arabia. So these are the top 5 spenders in military expenditure in the year 2019, and India is the third largest spender, right? Which country co-hosted the 11th Petersburg Climate Dialogue 2020 along with Germany? Germany ke saath kaun si country ne 11th Petersburg Climate Dialogue 2020 ko co-host kiya? So guys, the correct answer is D, UK. UK has co-hosted the 11th Petersburg Climate Dialogue 2020 along with Germany. Or UK is the president for the COP26 of United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. UNFCCC ka jo agla COP hona hai, uske liye jo presidency hai wo kiske paas hai? UK ke paas. And COP25 jo hua tha, that was in Madrid in the year 2019. Alright. Okay guys, so that's it for part 1 of flashcards for the month of April 2020. I hope you like the session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.